It marks the end of an era, with Australia Post set to call time on its daily letter deliveries, which have become financially unviable as Aussies turn their back on the lost art of letter writing. So, I am here to write a love letter to you, letters, an ode to papery correspondence.
Dear letters, for thousands of years you've kept us connected, offered us words of thanks, congratulations and love.
Your handwriting is like your DNA. It's like your fingerprint that only you can share with others.
Receiving a letter in the mail is a special delight, like getting a new piece of jewellery? A necklace. Hoarded in boxes by teenagers and grandmas, delivered across far corners of the globe, through world wars and depressions. From first words to first loves.
I mean, that's a beautiful thing. It's such a special thing. And that person that receives that letter is going to feel special.
Letters have been there. Handwriting a letter even has health benefits.
My hand is bloody killing me. How do people do this?
OK, so there are some downsides. But handwriting is good for stress levels, for motor skills and for memory.
It puts you at peace, it relaxes you, and it just gives you a break from other things that, you know, take up too much of your time.
And while an emoji-laden text or cold email won't keep you warm at night, letters are forever.
But imagine going to your letterbox and then someone's written your name and address on the envelope and you go inside and you open the letter and you, oh, wow, there's a 2 or 3 page letter that someone's actually sat down and written. It's a special moment. There's all these letters in drawers and in cupboards and in boxes. We still love you, letters. We haven't forgotten about you.
So adrift a tide of paper nostalgia, I'll bid you goodbye, letters, and long to hold you, read you again soon. All my love, Sarah.
Never received one of these letters from you.
Who are you sending those to? Not us.
I've got to say, though, I still have a box full of my high school boyfriend's letters high school. And I've, but I've kept them because it's just, it's such a lovely time in my life. It's like a time capsule. You could take them out every couple of years or maybe a decade and have a look through them. But I've carted them around from house to house for the last
Did you write ones back to your boyfriend, or was it just him writing them to you?
No, we wrote them to each other.
There's a corresponding box somewhere else.
Or maybe not. It's like an M&M stand situation.
Oh, no. We don't do that.
Never return them.
Oh, dear.
Letters and emails, they're just all so ephemeral, you know? Like, it's all disappeared. You need to do letters again. You write letters, don't you?
Yeah, well, it made me think. When I grew up in the country and got sent to boarding school, Dad used to write me a typed letter every week, and I've still got them all.
Really?
Wow. But he used to sign them like Dad, but then type underneath Ian A. McDonald.
Oh, the full name.
Yeah.
Yeah, just really in case you didn't realise who it's from.
Who this is coming from.
Do you go through them? Do you read them?
Not regularly, but I mean, whenever you move house or whatever, you pull them out and have a look, which I guess is the difference with emails, right? Because you're never going to go back through
the closest. I have something similar. My phone recently restored itself accidentally, and all my old WhatsApp messages came back. And then there were texts from my old girlfriend, and it hurt my feelings. Is that the same?
Like,
is that the
angry
same thing?
Text from
no, just like I had to re-see it. But that felt like an old letter. My archived WhatsApp chat.
So final on the same text. Page here? Delete my number.
Delete my number.
And just to reassure everyone watching at home, Australia Post has confirmed that all letters will make it to Santa in the North Pole on time, so do not stress about that.
Just deliver it every second day.
They will get paid.